as compared to list. So what is the major difference and where you can use the set in your real time project? So list, you know, working on internal data structure of the list is growable array, but the set having, you know, doesn't have a array internally. If you are storing the object inside this array, list, so we should not have any like a growable array, right? You know, flexible array like the list. It is working on the hashing algorithm. Hashing algorithm means, so we had discussed this last session we had discussed this, right? Collection, list, array, list, link list, vector, stat. Now we are going to discuss, and this is your, okay, I did not mention here all the things. So this is our set. So collection, we have a set. Implementation, this is your sub interface, and implementation class is HashSet, LinkHashet. These are the also the interface: sorted set, navigable set, and TreeSet. TreeSet is the sub in implementation class of navigable set. So what we will discuss, these are the important class we will going to explore: this HashSet, LinkHashet, and TreeSet. So what is the difference between list and set? Okay. As your automation testing profile, they will ask difference. So major difference of, you know, so major difference of list is, so what happened when you are creating a array list, then what happened, object is created, then internal data structure is growable array. So internally list, array list is working on this data structure, right? But in the set there is no internal data structure like growable array. Okay, this is working like that, right? So when you are storing any object, you know, if you want to store here add, okay, just I'm not able to write. Okay, so one second, the system is hanging. Okay, so just we are writing, no, add. Okay, like add, creating a array list, not writing all the things, array list. Okay, L equal to new array list. Okay, so we are creating an object, and object of an array list, and we are going to store here L dot add and any object. You are writing A. Okay, so everything is an object in collection, right? So we are writing like B. Okay, these are the object we are going to store inside this. So what is internally going to happen here? Object is created A, object is created B. So this is your reference 10 10. Okay, 10 10, this is your reference variable L, right? This object. Okay, now this is your reference variable 10 10 for reference variable L. Then value, how it is going to store value, is not going to store directly A here, because it is an object. If you are storing anything inside this collection, any collection, everything is an object, then what happened, it won't be stored directly here. Here object is created 2020 for A. Okay, here A is there, and this reference will store here 2020. Okay, then B, here is 3030, is going to store here. Okay, so it's store here 3030. So internally, internal data structure of list is this global array, but set doesn't have, you know, this type of data structure. Set, I'm not telling complete, you know, data structure of set, just we can visualize this. Set store this value, you know, one, if you will go in the internal data structure, it's very complicated. The people have developed, Java people have developed, you know, API. So we are going to use this, how to use your set, right? We are not going to implement this, but if we will go in the implementation, complete implementation. It's I'm not telling it is a difficult, but it is a complete data structure. And if you go as a developer, they can also ask, could you create own custom collection? So this is your high level of the coding. If you are interested, you can take the help of the Google to how to create your list. Okay, list is already created, but the customer or the client want to create a custom list. So this type of question they cannot ask in the automation testing profile. Might be some of the product based companies expecting this type of the question, but very less. They want to the features, how to use this. We are not going to implement this, right? Then what is the use of this API, right? There is no use, right? If you are going to develop, then what is the use of this? But why they are asking in the interview? They are checking your depth knowledge, how you are good in depth. Okay, so leave it. Just we have to understand how to use this. So what happened? Set having a bucket. Okay, so set is not having the internal data structure. It is working on the hashing algorithm. If you are storing anything inside the set, what happened? You know, the object will store like that. Okay, object will store like that, and this is, you know, internal data structure of set is hashing algorithm. Then this is the hash code, right? Every hash code is generated. Just I'm giving this, I'm not writing out 10 10 20 20, right? 10 10 20 20. So one difference between the set and list. Internal data structure is completely different from the list. List is working on global array, and it is, and if you are going to store the object inside this list, it is working on, it will store as an index, right? It is working on the index. But in the set, there is no index. It is not working on the index because the internal data structure is not an array. So internal data structure of list is hashing algorithm. Hashing means if you are storing, this bucket is there and this container is there, and you are going to store multiple objects inside this, and object means one hash code is there, right? So this is called hashing algorithm. Second difference of the set is the duplicates are not allowed in the set, but in the list, duplicate objects are allowed. Where we can use this set? If you have a searching algorithm, you have to use the searching algorithm in your project, then we should go for set. I don't want to store the duplicate object, then we should go for set. These are the major difference between set and list. Okay, so we have to tell like that. Okay, so set is the sub interface of collection. If you want to represent a group of objects in a single entity where duplicates are not allowed and insertion order is not preserved. If you will execute this, there is no order. If you will store this object, there is no order. It will display randomly. Okay, there is no order for this object if you will display. So insertion order is not preserved for the set. This is the another difference. In the list, insertion order is preserved. Okay, so this is your second difference of the list. Set interface does not contain any new method. We have to use only collection interface method. Here there is no new method is there. Whatever the method which is present inside this collection, same method we will use inside this set. So we have our internal data implementation class is HashSet. So the underlying data structure is HashTable. HashTable is nothing but it is also the legacy class. HashTable is legacy class. How they have developed this HashSet? So HashSet HashTable is a also class, legacy class, and the internal data structure of HashTable is hashing algorithm. Right? So that's why the internal data structure is HashSet. Duplicates object are not allowed. Insertion order is not preserved. It is based on the hash code of an object, right? I already discussed. Null insertion is possible only once. Heterogeneous objects are allowed. And every collection, it's serializable and clonable interface is there, but your random access is not there. So I already discussed regarding what is meaning of this serializable and clonable. So these are the marker interface, why we are using this. When you are, you know, we have a one class, and we inside this one class I have developed this like logic where you can use the set. Inside this set you have a store 100 employee of the data. That data I want to use in the another class. So simply what happen, it will copy one location to another location, all this object. How it is going to happen? Because of these are marker interface internally. Okay, HashSet is the best choice if our frequent operation is search. Searching operation is there, then we should go for HashSet. Okay, so in HashSet, duplicates are not allowed. We know duplicates are not allowed. If you will store the duplicate, then what happens? We won't get any compile time error or runtime. And add method simply return false. So duplicates are not allowed. They will ask the cross question. If I will store the duplicate object, then what will happen? Will I get compile time error or runtime error? No. We won't we get any compile time error and runtime error. Simply we will get the output is false. Okay. So we should go for this example. Hey, collection is not a tough topic, okay? If you have a good concept of object, why we are creating an object, okay? Complete, you know, object only, collection having the object, and what is having interface, class and method. Apart from this I did not get anything, right? So important thing is your basics. If you will go in the Selenium profile and if you prepare very well my all the syllabus and notes, you will enjoy with your work. You will get problem will come, exception will come, error will come, but you are able to understand why this error is coming. Many errors will come, you are not able to understand. Search on the Google and you will get the solution, and you are able to, you know, grab that solution. Oh, that's why this is going to happen. So that's why this error is coming. Okay, so if you will learn all the things whatever I am teaching you, it is helpful for code Java as well, and Python having also the same concept. Okay, so if you are strong in the Java, then you can grab the Python easily, very easy. Even many things is you have to not write. Okay, so if you grab all this core Java, and I will suggest you side by side start to learn Python, because nowadays in my company is also every application of develop on the core Java, but they are also hiring the Python people. Okay, so coming features is Python. Java will be there, but less opportunity to the Java. Okay. I'm not telling Java is completely gone. It will take more time because Java is also doing some enhancement. coming features of the Java, they are also adding the library. Why Python is more, you know, because this is the completely open source, and Python having the huge library. You cannot do the mathematical calculation by using the code Java, but Python having the mathematical calculation, right? So that is, you know, data science, and we have a machine learning. So they have developed all this library. Library means they having the modules and function, and okay, so simply they are going to use this, and code is very short. So if you will grab this Java and get the job, no problem. Okay, if you are have a time, start to learn Python side by side, because at least many companies are looking, do you have a basics knowledge of Python or not? I'm getting call also like that, do you have a basics knowledge of Python or not? They are asking, at least you have a basics. Okay, so second language is your Python, but it is very easy to learn. You already know the code Java. So what this example is doing, I have created an object, I'm going to store duplicates. Okay, so you know, the first is true and second is what, false, because I have added duplicates. This thing I want to show you. Okay, we have a constructor. So every class is having the constructor, and create an empty hash object with the default initial capacity is 60, and default fill ratio or load factor is 0.7. so this is the one constructor. When you will create this empty constructor, we can initialize initial capacity also, then create an empty hash code, hash set object with a specified and default fill ratio is 0.7 only. Here we have another constructor, initial capacity and float fill ratio. So we can pass both argument here, and here you can pass any collection. Create an equivalent hash set for given collection, and this constructor meant for interconversion between the collection object. So just I have give you one simple example, but you guys will do the practice for the site I already shared with you, and search in your Google, you can get many example with collection. Okay, so it's very helpful, because my notes will help you for your theory, but practice, you have to coding practice, you have to do yourself. Okay, my notes will help you for your what is this? But for coding, you have to do practice yourself, because I am telling the, you know, how to giving the overview of this, right? And theory is, my notes is enough for practical. Okay, how to do the practical, and this coding, how to increase your coding skill. So just search on the Google, you will get many website. Some of the website is also there, some requirement is there, you have to develop the code. Okay, they having the like requirement, so you have to develop that code. If you will make the habit to like that, then day by day you can grab it. Okay, you are not able to understand the Google code, what you have to do, write on your paper and execute line by line all the code on your system. Okay, if you will do like that, you are able to grab the code also, Google code logic, different logic, and having a more line of the logic, because I am also doing the same. If I'm not able to understand the another logic, okay, so like that. Okay, so just I have a store this all this object inside this null value I'm going to passing here, and here I am also passing this duplicates. Here we'll get the false, because we have already this, right? And just printing this. Okay, so same method, add method, whatever the method which is available in the collection, same method we will apply inside this, you know, set also. Okay, so why this value is coming first, because we are going to store the duplicates. Okay, so this is your hash set. Okay, we have a link hash set. So this is the, it is a subclass of hash set. Hash set having the subclass of link hash set. It is same like the hash set, but we have a including everything, method, constructor, everything having the same, but we have a difference. So every difference is important, and 80% to 90% and automation testing profile, they will ask difference, what is the difference between this and this. So that's why I have written here very very important for difference. So difference at least you have to know, and at least you have a basics how to store your object inside this. At least minimum you have to know this, and maximum is your effort and your practice. Okay, so underlying data structure is hash table. Here we have a link list and hash table both, that's why it is called link hash set. Okay, insertion order is not pager. Here pager, why? Because we have a link list. Okay, it is introduced in 1.2 version and it is introduced in 1.4 version. So this is your link hash set. So link hash set, I'll show you the, we will get output difference. Okay, here we will get some difference of the output for hash set and link hash set. Okay, just I change this. So same thing, you know, just I change this object here. Here I am going to use link hash set. That's it. Everything is same, but internal data structure is here link list plus hash table, and hash set having the hash set one. So what I have mentioned here, here insertion order is not preserved, here insertion order is preserved. So when you will execute this code, just I am going to close all this command prompt. This way, when I will compile this code here, you know, we are getting this output. Okay, null bcd. When you will execute this code, sometime it depend upon here, you know, you can see the, here the insertion order is preserved. The value how you are going to store, same output it is coming, right? A, B, C, D, Z, null and 10. But if you will go inside this hash table, the output is, sorry, hash set, then output is different, right? Here you can see. Okay, so here insertion order is preserved, here insertion order is not preserved. Why? Because we have an internal data structure of linked list plus hash table. Okay, so this is your major difference. If you will ask what is the difference between the hash table and link hash table, then you have to tell this, you have to highlight this point. Okay, so this is your, we have a same thing I have mentioned. Okay, sorted set. So sorted set is the sub interface of set. If you want to represent a group of object according to the sorting order and without duplicate, then we should go for sorted set. That is fine. Sorted set means if you will create an object of this sorted set. Now this is the sorted set, is an interface, might be some implementation classes therefore there. But here if you want to duplicate, you don't want to duplicate. Okay, and we have a sorted object, then we should go for the sorted set. Okay, so it is not too much important. We have a, this is the important tree set. So tree set having the different functionality, this is the complete data structure. So underlying data structure is balanced tree. Okay, balanced tree means it is the part of data structure. So tree data structure I'm not going to discuss here, just go through once Google and how this tree, you know, data structures tree is going to work, you will get some idea about this. Okay, but don't worry about it. You are able to understand this tree set. But we have a balanced tree here. Duplicates are not allowed. Heterogeneous objects are not allowed. You can see now, before whatever we have learned, heterogeneous objects are allowed for every collection, but here heterogeneous objects are not allowed, otherwise we will get runtime exception. And what the exception will come? Class cast exception. Okay, so this point is, I commented this, leave it this point. So TreeSet implement same serializable, clonable, and but not a random access, and all the objects will be inserted on the sorting order. So if you are going to store any object inside this tree set, every object having a default sorting order. Okay, or here one more functionality is there for tree set. If you want to develop the customized sorting order, we can go through this tree set. So tree set internal data structure is balanced tree. Heterogeneous objects are not allowed, and duplicates object are not allowed also. If you will try to store this heterogeneous, then what happens? We will get class cast exception. Okay, in tree set we have a default sorting order. If you want to own customized sorting order, we can implement and we can develop this code by using this tree set. So tree set having this constructor tree set, creating this and create an empty tree set object where element will be inserted according to sort default sorting order. Okay, if you are storing anything, it will display the output default sorting order by using this constructor. We have a tree set, and here you can see I pass here comparator. So what is meaning of the comparator? Coming session we will discuss. Okay, we will use this constructor. Okay, so create an empty tree set object where element will be inserted according to customized sorting order. If you have a requirement to customize sorting order, I want to display the object in the descending order, okay, then we should go for this constructor. How to use this? By using this comparator. Okay, so what is the comparator and all, I will discuss in the coming session. So customized sorting order is specified by the comparator, and another, we can pass any collection. Okay, this is the another constructor. Here we can pass sorted set also. This is the another constructor. So we'll see this one basics example of this tree set. Okay, so now in tree set heterogeneous are not allowed. Okay, so you can see I have stored all this object in the string, right? So just I'm not going to do anything. Okay, so now just I have a store this, and I'm going to execute this. Tree set object is created and going to a store in this. Okay, so you can see I'm getting this output ABC LZ A. So this is in the default sorting order, right? We had already discussed. If you will try to a store heterogeneous, we won't we get any compile time error. Compiler is checking one syntax, but if you will execute this code, then we will get runtime exception, class cast exception. A string cannot be converted into, cannot be cast to java.lang integer, right? Because I already told you, right, if you are storing anything inside this collection, internally auto boxing is happen. What happens? This integer type data type is converted into the integer class. So that's why we are getting this. This exception cannot be cast to java.lang.integer class. Okay, so here one more thing. And if you want to store null inside this tree set, okay, then if I will compile this, we won't we get any compile time error. But if we will run this, we will get null pointer exception. So I think we had already discussed for all this collection null is allowed at once or okay, but here if we will try to store this null, then we will get what? Null pointer exception runtime. What is meaning of null? Null. What do you meaning of null? Hey, I already discussed. Null is the default value of object. Okay. You know, integer default value of 0. So null is the default value of object. A string default value of null. Okay. Okay. So for empty, non-empty tree set, if you are trying to insert in the null, we will get null pointer exception. For empty tree set, first element is null is allowed. Okay, leave it. Just we have to remember this all the things what I had discussed. Until 1.6 version null is allowed. Okay. Before and till 1.6 null was allowed, but now from 1.7 onwards null is not allowed for tree set. If you will try to store the null, we will get what? We will get null pointer exception. Okay. I having one more code, and this is the interesting code, and from here you can learn new points, and we have to observe this. Okay. Because this is your important point. If you are not able to understand, so you will face the difficulties for coming classes. Okay. So we have a one class and storing this and storing this object inside this tree set. What class I took here? A string buffer. A string buffer object I am going to store inside this tree set, right? Hey, I already discussed, right, how this value is going to store, right? I cannot tell you completely, but I can tell you this. This is your tree set, just consider, and this is your all object. Okay, which object? And you can see this, you can see how it is going to store. It won't be going to store directly, right? So what happened? The hash code will be stored inside this if you will go in the internally, right? This is your a string buffer object, and you are storing this a value, right? So one hash code and this hash code will store here, right? So we should go for concept here. Hash code here, a is there, right? Like that it will store. Okay, so think like that. So this all this a string buffer I'm going to store inside this tree set. I'm going to display, but what happened? You can see if I will compile this code, able to compile and able, but we are getting this class cast exception. A string buffer cannot be cast to java.lang comparable. Okay, we should, you know, concentrate on this point. What the JVM is asking, JVM is throwing this exception, and what the message they are providing? JVM is providing the message java.lang.string. java.lang, lang is the package coming from a string buffer classes, cannot be cast to this java.lang.comparable. Okay, so why this exception is coming? Before I was executing first code, I was not getting any exception. That is the, I think if you will observe, that is the string, right? A string literal we were storing directly here. This is our string, right? Here we won't be get any exception, but if you are trying to store a string buffer object, then we were getting this class cast exception, and the JVM is telling this cannot be cast to comparable. So here the story will start with comparable. Okay, so what do you mean of this example? We are getting this class cast exception. If you are depending on default natural sorting order, compulsory objects should be homogeneous, because heterogeneous are not allowed. If you want to display what default sorting order, what the condition a tree set is following. So first condition is object should be homogeneous and comparable. Okay, so a string is comparable, otherwise we will get runtime exception. So if you want to display your default sorting order, we must follow two conditions. First condition is object must be homogeneous and object must be comparable. If these two conditions are not there, then we will get class cast exception. Okay, I am going to explain why we are getting this class cast exception. An object is said to be comparable. Okay, in which object is comparable? If and only if corresponding class implements comparable interface. So in the string, by default comparable is there. We can go through this string. We can see string by default comparable is there. Okay, so if I will go inside this string and a string buffer, two classes we are going to use this now. You can see we have a comparable, right? java.lang.string package implement the interface serializable, char sequence and comparable. Okay, here a string final class, you know, a string is final class, extend object implement serializable, comparable and char sequence. In the string buffer, let's see, here no comparable is there, right? You can see. So in the string buffer, final class is there, that is fine. Serializable is there, but here no comparable is there. Okay, so for displaying your default order of an object, we must follow two conditions. Object must be comparable if and only corresponding class implement comparable interface. A string class and all wrapper classes already implements comparable interface, but a string buffer class does not implement comparable interface. Hence, we got class cast exception. Okay, so I'm going to stop your session. So I will send you these notes.